My name is Guy Young. I'm the director of the School for the Arts here at Taze Valley, and we wish to extend a hearty welcome to you all, to all who have come this evening, our wonderful guests here this evening. There are so many, many people to thank and to acknowledge. And after the concert program, before the reception, we have a little surprise for all of you. And so please stay seated after the artists finish their last musical performance. I wish to acknowledge this evening, before the intermission, the role of several agencies and individuals that have made this possible. First of all, we wish to thank the Charleston Conservatory of Music and Fine Arts for their tremendous vision in bringing this caliber of musicians to the Kanawha Valley and to West Virginia. And we're very grateful for them. We have several of the members of the administration and faculty here this evening. All three artists in the performance tonight are artists at the conservatory and teachers and instructors. R.E.A. Lipsky is the artist in residence this year, and we're so grateful for the conservatory's role in bringing such fine programs to West Virginia. We also wish to thank Mr. Jim Andrews and the Department of Arts and Humanities of the Culture and History Division in Charleston for the partial funding of this program with a grant of Endowment for the Arts monies and West Virginia monies. And we're so grateful tonight for these wonderful institutions that bring this quality of life to West Virginia. We feel that this evening is a dream come true for us to be able to have these artists and to be able to honor the nation of Israel. We are very, very privileged and thrilled tonight to do so. I want to speak for just a moment about the School for the Arts and its role in the community. We do bring performances throughout the year to Taze Valley, to Putnam County, and to Kanawha County, and we're finding that the response of the community, the businesses, the private sector, is tremendous. I think people are telling us that they want this kind of quality music and art in Taze Valley. So we're so grateful for your support and your being here this evening. The School for the Arts was founded 2.5 years ago, and we sponsor an art gallery in which tonight you will find a marvelous exhibition of the works of Sandra Bowden, biblical themes in Hebrew calligraphy and intaglio, and later on in the evening we'll be introducing Mrs. Bowden to you after the concert.
I'm very privileged to play this piece for you this evening. Mr. Stochevsky was my grandfather artistically. He was a teacher of my cello teacher in Israel. And I couldn't find any cello piece that he wrote, and he wrote many. And I just find a flute piece, which is very nice. And so I'll share it with you.
Thank you. Thank you.
I would like to introduce several people this evening, special guests who are in the audience. And as they are seated, and we would like to make a special presentation to each of these guests who are here this evening. First of all, and I will be giving you a little more information about this gentleman later on, we would like to welcome, and will you please give applause to the Honorable Benjamin Abeleya, Consul General of Israel in Washington. Would you stand? Then we have a wonderful, wonderful couple here this evening, very responsible for the music that is here, what you see this evening, and very special people who are here from Akkor, Israel, Mr. and Mrs. Eliezer Yampel, the parents of Rachel Lipsky. Would you give them a hand, please? Stand, please. Thank you. Then we're very privileged to have this evening with us beautiful, beautiful couple who have come from England to reside in Charleston in the and they are the are new, I think they're fairly new in the community, but we're very glad to have them. Rabbi and Mrs. Chaim Landau from B'nai Jacob Synagogue. Will you stand, please? It's a pleasure. And then a very, very special friend to us, to this congregation. It is through this gentleman and that we are able to have Mr. Abeleya as a guest this evening. I called him one day to talk about kosher laws, about a reception, and then I got a reference to Mr. Abeleya, and I called and he so graciously accepted our invitation. But we want to introduce a gentleman and his wife. They're very special to us, the congregations of these two bodies in Charleston are very special to us. And I would like to introduce Rabbi and Mrs. Israel Kohler from Congregation B'nai Israel. Would you stand and let us honor them? Another individual that we would like to honor tonight is a very, very wonderful, wonderful young lady. We've met her recently and have made her acquaintance, and she has the beautiful exhibit this evening in the Krim Gallery. This is Sandra Bowden from Clifton Park, New York. Would you stand and let's honor her. I want to compliment you before I make this next introduction for your freedom and your response tonight to the artists. It's wonderful when we come into a place like this. Many times the atmosphere, the aura surrounding the fine arts has been that of snobbery and exclusiveness, and we'd like to change that here. We want us to be comfortable and enjoy this, and I'm so glad to see so many smiles and so many people enjoying this evening. That now, the reason that we are having a program like this evening, and the reason that we have what we see here, this beautiful sanctuary, and the vision and the interest in the fine arts as being a part of a sacramental view of the universe, these reasons for this are because of a gentleman who came here 14 years ago to become the senior pastor of this church. This gentleman and his love and his concern and his compassion for people of all the earth have inspired this wonderful ministry and program together here at Scott Depot Christ Fellowship, Taze Valley Christian School, and the School for the Arts. And I would like to introduce to you this gentleman who will come and share a few words before the special music. This is Pastor Oliver C. Hoag. Would you welcome him?
Thank you. there is another couple here that we want to honor tonight, but not expecting this honor at all. But in no small way, they've had a part in what is happening here at the Scott Depot Christ Fellowship. This couple has influenced my life almost more than any other couple, for it was through them that I was taught to be non-sectarian. It was through them that I was taught that all creation with reference to humanity is equal. It was through them that I was taught that I must esteem others better than myself. And it was through them that the whole world opened up to me in religious things by teaching me that I must do God's will. Of course, I'm speaking of my parents, which are, instead of retiring, they came here to be the associate pastors. That's my mother and father, the Reverend and Mrs. Everett Hogue. Mom and Dad, would you stand? Secondly, the person most influential in my life and in our life, the congregation here, is the gentleman mentioned in the program, Reverend Helm. He couldn't be with us tonight. He's not able to be, but is due in for services next week. But I was thinking about his part in all of this. And I think, although I could say many things about how something like this came to pass, I think this is the most important thing. Secondly, the person most influential in my life and in our life, the congregation here, is the gentleman mentioned in the program, Reverend Helm. He couldn't be with us tonight. He's not able to be, but is due in for services next week. But I was thinking about his part in all of this. And I think, although I could say many things about how something like this came to pass, I think this is the most important thing. With the background of my parents, when I met this gentleman in 1966, I had been praying for many years that I could meet a man who walked with God like the men of the Bible. And I prayed that prayer early in my youth. I thought Elijah was great. I thought Moses was great. I thought all of the Bible prophets were great. But I wanted to meet a live one for myself, because Malachi says that God changes not. And if God changes not, he has prophets today as he did in days of old. And I needed someone. I need to see someone who walked with God like they did in the Bible. God let me meet that man, Reverend Helm, in 1966, and my heart has never been disappointed. It was Reverend Helm that has taken us to Israel 15 times. And this congregation helped earn the Shalom Award, because this congregation has gone more than any other congregation under his ministry in the United States, that is, numerically. We have approximately maybe 150 people. I might let you see their hands. How many in this congregation have been to Israel with us? Would you put your hand up? How many of you have been, thank you. How many of you have been numerous times? Would you put your hand up? You can see these have traveled. And because of you, that the Shalom Award came out of this congregation. Now this point must be emphasized. In 1969, when we came, and in 70, he simply said to me, Oliver, the Holy Spirit is telling me to go to Israel. That's how we started. When we went to Israel, even on the first trip, he said to me, the Holy Spirit is telling us we must come back. We did not know the meaning of what was taking place. We didn't try to figure it out. We just kept going, and we kept going, and we kept going. After a while, they begin to say in Israel, you do not come to see the Holy Land sites. You are coming to see us because you love us. That's why we kept going. Now I've been privileged to be 15 to Israel 15 times. It is a sacred duty, and it's because of the will of God. We knew not what we know now, and it's just beginning to open up. God wanted us to go to Israel, and because of His will, we found the chosen of God, and we feel chosen also that we should have this wonderful privilege of embracing the people of Israel. And how can you embrace a nation if you do not embrace all of the Jewish people of the earth? It is an impossibility. They are a nation. And we are privileged as a congregation, fellowship here, to have these here tonight. How can I say how I feel? I have no planned remarks, but this is pouring out of my heart. Can I say how I feel? I never dream that so distinguished official as Benjamin Abelea would be in our midst tonight. Rachel's parents, Rabbi Kohler and Mrs. Kohler, and Rabbi Londo and his wife. It's the greatest thing. I think that Sandra symbolizes it in her creation, in the foyer, as I came in and found it. The rainbow, the promise. It is a promise that has really come true for us. And I wanted to give a gift to all of you and to all of our Jewish people and for the sake of Israel by opening our program with something that's unexpected. I thought with the promise, with the rainbow, we'd have to open our gift to them with one that Jeannie does, with the rainbow song itself. Because something has happened tonight, unique and great, and it is so sacred and so precious, we must give God the glory and the praise. We've sung it for years, we've heard it sung, but you'll hear it in song tonight, a desire to fly over the rainbow. Let's make our contribution. Come on up, young people, to our Jewish friends and in honor of the nation of Israel. After they sing this first number, the next number or two, I think they'll speak for themselves as they present their sharings with us tonight.
Yeah. ve'al kol Yisrael ve'ifru ifru amen. Yaseh shalom shalom aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael. Yaseh shalom, shalom aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael. Yaseh shalom, shalom aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael. Yaseh shalom, shalom aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael. Oseh shalom bimromav, uyaseh shalom aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael. Ve'ivru, ivru, amen. Oseh shalom bimromav, uyaseh shalom aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael. Ve'ivru, ivru, amen. Yaseh shalom, shalom aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael. 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 Israel, my love, Israel, my promised, chosen of God, chosen for me, homeland forever, land of Messiah, Israel, my love, our God watches thee. Are the walls of Jerusalem standing? Do our fathers sleep in peace where they lay? Is the stranger gone? Has he left our land? Can we live? Can we breathe? Can we pray? Does the Jew stand fast in Galilee? Does the Jordan still roll to the sea? Can the Lord come home to the land He loves? Can we live? Can we pray? Can we be? Israel, my love, Israel, my promised, chosen of God, chosen for me, homeland forever, land of Messiah, Israel, my love, our God watches thee. Does the rose still bloom in the desert? Does the olive tree bask in the sun? Can the children laugh? Is the soldier home? Is the age-old fighting dog? Has Messiah come? Has the King returned? Are we saved? Oh, blessed be He. When Messiah comes to the land He loves, we can live, we can pray, we can be. Israel, my love, Israel, my promised, chosen of God. Chosen for me, homeland forever, land of Messiah, Israel, my love, our God watches thee. God gave this land to me, this brave and ancient land to me. And when the morning sun reveals her hills and plains, I can see a land where children can run free. So take my hand and walk this land with me, and walk this lovely land with me.
We want to commend these young people and this beautiful soloist and their pianist and director, Sally Davis. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We want to acknowledge the privilege that we have in having this special guest with us this evening. Mr. Abileya was so gracious. I called the embassy and I expected to go through a chain of secretaries, and this gentleman came on the telephone, and from the very beginning he was so gracious and kind, and he made me feel very at ease and at home. Mr. Abileya comes to us as a native of Israel, as a career diplomat in that country, and he has served in many, many significant and distinguished positions in the foreign ministry of Israel, in many embassies, and has had a very broad experience serving his country and his nation abroad. Most recently, he was selected to come in 1982, in the summer, a year ago, to fill the new post of Consul General in Washington. And his jurisdiction is in the District of Columbia, Maryland, Virginia, West Virginia, North Carolina. We're so glad that it comes over the mountains to us, aren't you? And we're so pleased that he would come with us this evening. We feel very honored in welcoming the Honorable Benjamin Abileya. Would you come?
I'm speechless. This is so overwhelming. I wish so much that more of my colleagues at the embassy would have the chance to come over the mountains to places like this in the United States. I've had a few such opportunities, not only for getting away from their daily, sometimes unpleasant chores in the Capitol, but also to really tear themselves away from all of this and plainly enjoy the company of good Americans with whom it is wonderful to be together. How can I thank you? You chose so well to honor Israel with music. I suppose all of us have something for music in them. I think that of all forms of art, the one in which Israel really excels for quite some time already is music. Music is a language. And with this language, we have been telling about our hardships, about our wishes, our hopes, our concerns. Two of the three most beautiful songs that you've heard played here by our artists this evening came out of wars, but they're songs of hope. Lu Yehi, a prayer, and Yerushalayim Shel Zahav, the love for the Jerusalem, the golden. Our early pioneers brought music to a land that was a desert in music as well. Then those who fled from Hitler's Europe brought music to the country. Perhaps because of them, we were able to establish one of the best philharmonic orchestras in the world, which to date, I might tell you, is probably holding the record in sales of subscriptions. It is statistically true, that more concert tickets are being sold to Israelis per capita than any other people in the world. We do delve into other form of arts, literature. We're supposed to be the people of the book. Well, little Israel of 4 million people has published last year 3,700 books. And a bestseller in Israel sells between 40 and 50,000 copies. This is the number of copies a bestseller sells in France, which is a little bigger. So we can be very proud, but of the music, I think we can be the proudest. So thank you indeed. And to thank you fully, I really do not know how except use the words of the song you sang, when you come to Israel, if any of you hasn't been in Israel yet, when you come to Israel, consider yourself one of us. Thank you.
Before we do dismiss this evening to be taken to the foyer, because of the large number of people, there are some problems logistically. Some of you might want to take your refreshments, go through the art gallery. There's a lovely music room with chairs and seating for if you would wish to come here, and then it is a stand-up reception. Before we are dismissed, the ushers will come and will take our distinguished guests, Mr. and Mrs. Yampel, Reverend Mrs. Hoag, Mr. Abileya, Sandra Bowden, the rabbis and their wives, will be dismissed first, please. And ushers, will you come now and take them to the front of the line? And then people who are from Scott Depot, from the church and school, let us let our guests go first this evening. Also, of course, the musicians will go, and somebody will take care of their instruments and put them where they'll be safe. And we want to thank you for coming this evening. It may have been a little long for some of you, but isn't it better than what's on television tonight? I'm thankful. We're so grateful for your support and kindness. And in closing, we just want to say that beautiful word that we hear our Israeli friends say, Shalom, Shalom. Thank you.